Hello everyone, welcome to ComScholar. In this video, I will explain you different types of groups and how they are different from each other. Now first, let's take group 7. In 1970, after world shock, oil crisis, economics of all over the world was suffering and global leaders wanted to do something about it. So, a group of officials of the world decided to meet and make a concrete decision to sort out the problem. At first, in 1975, there was just 6 countries such as France, Germany, Italy, Japan, UK and US. And in the following years, Canada also joined, and then the group named as G7. Then in 1988, Russia also joined the club and make it to G8. But in 2014, after the annexation of Crimea from Ukraine, Russia moved out and the group back to G7. The countries and the attendants typically discuss broad issues like climate change, future jobs and women empowerment. Basically, group 7 is an informal group. So whatever said during these meetings is just a finding. It's always a great opportunity for all the members to exchange ideas. But there are some other global powers are also missing, such as India and China, because earlier some say the G7 doesn't represent the world at large, which brings to group 20. Now, in the beginning of 1999, after massive global financial crisis, the Group 7 found India and China moving towards emerging developing countries. So they feel to add all some other developing countries such as India, China, Brazil, Indonesia, so that they can also participate in international forum discussion making with industrial national nations, those who already part of G7. So now G7 basically for the to meet the financial stability in the world. Now the group 20 basically comprises of 19 countries plus European countries. The countries are Argentina, Australia, Brazil, Canada, China, France, Germany, India, Indonesia, Italy, Japan, Republic of Korea, Mexico, Russia, Saudi Arabia, South Africa, Turkey, UK, US and European Unions. The Group 20 represents 85% of global economic output. Initially, only the finance minister and the governor participate in this group 20. But since 2008, world leader also start joining like prime minister. Now, what are the important facts of this group 20? Why is it so important? In 2014, when Russia moved out from G8, they are not getting any financial sanction in oil sector. So their weightage of G20 gradually increased, as there are already other developing countries are part of it, such as India and China. Now what is the purpose of this group 20? The main purpose is to bring together systematically important for industrialized developing countries to discuss key issues in the global economy. Now the next group is group 4. First, let's talk about the P5. What is P5? Permanent 5 countries. The permanent 5 countries comprises of France, UK, China, Russia and USA. The all countries will work together to promote global peace, security, resilience and equity. There are some other countries also wanted to join in permanent seats in UNSA, that is United Nations Security Councils, but they failed to do so. So they decided to create their own group, that is G4. What are those countries? Brazil, Germany, India and Japan, so that they can support each other's bid. But it is not easy task to be a part of United Nations Security Council. They need to get through from many phases, like Japan's bid always opposed by South Korea, Brazil's bid always opposed by Latin America, Colombia, Argentina and Mexico, and obviously India's bid always opposed by Pakistan. So all the opposing countries, these all opposing countries also there have their own group, which is called COPEC group, and their meeting usually held yearly to make decision how to oppose their bid, those who are included in G4. But there are still some doubts whether this group is highly active or not. Now the council of P5 basically comprises of P5 plus non-permanent countries also. Yesterday we got news, India are also now a part of non-permanent countries like yesterday news, India has been elected as an non-permanent member of the United Nations Security Council for the 8th time, securing the seats of the Asia Pacific group. India got 184 out of 192 valid votes polled. Non-permanent members are elected for a 2-term year, with newly elected members teams set to begin in January 2020. So, which means India is also a part of non-permanent countries now. So, these are all about the different types of groups. I hope you understand this very well. Thank you. Please keep like and subscribe my channel.